Hi everybody, welcome back Ancient Warfare with me, Sid, and since last episode, I've done, well, nothing over there. Arnold's still a little bit lost, but, and it's nearly night time. It doesn't matter, we can head up to the castle, because there's a bed up there. So we can show you what we've been up to, but I've got the crenellations pretty much done on this side and all the way round. I've done some wall extending. Bridge still needs doing, but yeah, that's that will come with time. So this is kind of spread all the way round now. Now internally I've got a little tower thing going on up there, and then this is where I want to make the grand banquet hall kind of affair. There's going to be a roof which is going to be set down slightly from that. I'm not sure entirely how we're going to do the roof in here, but we'll work it out. So yeah, we got that kind of thing going on. Let me just take a few, oops, oh well, doesn't matter, it's only cobble. So what I was thinking was having the windows framed off in a slightly different stone to the rest of the place, and then we're going to have a very grand floor, great big banqueting table, lots of chairs, and you know, make it look pretty damn nice. I'm kind of think the best way to tackle this castle is by room and function within the room. So we've got no walkways around the top, but the walls come all the way around here. They'll kind of merge into the central tower, keep, whatever you want to call it, here. Pardon me, just a little bit of a belch there. So let's just quickly sleep the night off. What's that creeper doing? Where is it? I can see him on the map. He's down there somewhere. He's obviously very stealthy, because I can't see him. Yeah, B-52 stealth creeper. Anyway. And I'm thinking I'm going to go with purple glass, because it's me, purple, my colour, you know, we're sticking with that. So, yeah, we've got some stuff going on around in here, anyway. And what I should have brought some dirt. But what I thought we'd have is, if I can, yeah, I'm going to need to get up one, aren't I, to at least to take that lot out. But kind of, as I say, frame the windows in a different textured stroke coloured stone. Hup, hup. Right, so we need to take that and that out, and then like that. So it just, it's not particularly three dimensional, unfortunately, but once we get some glass in these, we'll start to get a feel, I think, for what I'm aiming for. Hopefully we will, anyway. Okay, let's have a look. So that's a start there. I'm going to need to get some dirt. I'll get these other, well, I won't get these other windows. I need to make some more glass and stuff. Fairly rich coloured floor, I think. As I say, ceiling, probably not that one, but there. So the kind of ceiling will be set down from the wall. I'm going to have some kind of minstrel's gallery going on up here as well, I think. So let me go and grab a few bits and pieces together, and we'll get on and try and make this place look a little bit special. All right. So I've got the windows in. They look very purple. And I brought a little bit of spruce to start off with. I think spruce for the floor. I'm going to use a mixture of spruce and birch. I would have preferred dark oak. I don't have any. So spruce is the next best thing. And I am going to go with these fairly... I'd say the dark oak texture just looks like it's been polished compared to this. This looks quite matte. Whereas the dark oak and acacia wood really does look like it's had a good layer of wax on it, and it's just such a richer colour. But, you know, beggars and choosers and all those things. So I'm going to try and come up with a pattern for the floor, I think. Maybe something like that at that end. Similar at this end. A bit more. Then we'll have run some spruce down the middle. There's no particular rhyme or reason why this pattern. It is just the pattern. Sometimes it's nice just to do the Minecraft equivalent of get a pad and paper and just doodle. And that's kind of what I tend to do with floors, to be honest. I'll come up with a very loose design and then just doodle with it, really. And that's not quite right, but I'll try to remember that bit. And that kind of sums up sometimes. There are times when you've got this absolutely brilliant design, it's absolutely perfect in your head, and you do it and everybody goes, wow, that's really nice, and you know, you can sit there satisfied with a job well done. And there's sometimes, and that may be a floor design, it may be a building, it may be anything that you do. Might be, you know, some wonderful fully automated system in Feed the Beast, you know, a technical modded thing. Doesn't really matter. You're just working on the basis that you had a solid design in your head when you started, and when you put it together, it works. And then sometimes it's better to work with a very flexible, loose design in your head, and then as it grows, you can almost organically just add to the mix. Make it. Why have I only got 32 there? Well, because I only did 16, of course, idiot. That's simple reason there. Yeah, so it kind of just grows. And I've got no idea what this is. Kind of a nut, almost like a nut, really. We'll just stick with it. Yeah, and just let it grow on it and see how it kind of fits in your own mind's eye as to where the design is going. Now, if I continued the thing here, these two here would be white, but I think that would look silly. I'm seeing a brain for some reason. Now, you could sit there and look at it and go, actually, I absolutely hate that. And again, there's nothing wrong with that. Rip it up, start over. You know, the worst you've done is used a bit of your durability on your tools. And let's be honest, they are virtual digital tools in a virtual world. And in the grand scheme of things, they really don't matter. You know, the times I have seen arguments on servers because so-and-so stole my so-and-so, or so-and-so killed me and lost my so-and-so and stuff. And you would honestly think sometimes that this was something real, that, you know, they really had a diamond pickaxe and so-and-so lost their diamond pickaxe, their real diamond pickaxe, you know, that was made out of a solid 2,000 carat diamond. And it's like, guys, it's a game, it's made up, it's not real, get over it, you know. And I do think some people do often take these things absolutely far too seriously, and can get into a game to the point where, you know, not just obsessing about the game, but getting obsessed to the point of what's the word I'm looking for, of the game taking over. And, you know, it's and it's dangerous. So yeah, it does look like a brain a bit, or like two kind of footprints, but it'll do. It's not bad. I'm not loving it, I'm not hating it either. It's just one of those things what is, shall we say. So then we need we need to get you out of the way for starters. We're going to need I think to raise this section up. Now I could do with, in all honesty, a crafting bench. And of course, you know, I'm not going to lie about needing a crafting bench. That would be the single most pointless thing to. So we'll raise that up, so we'll have a podium at the end for the Lord's what's the word? I can't do anything with those when they're chiseled, can I? That's a real shame. That'll give me nowhere near enough, so let us grab that. Maybe do that. A little bit of that going on. I should have brought some carpenter's blocks with me, but I didn't, so, you know. There you go. There's 12 of those, and we can maybe just do that. I'm not sure whether we even need to bother. Do we want to? It's difficult, isn't it? What do we want to do? We take you out, pop that in. Yeah, I suppose. I suppose for completeness, that does look better than anything else, really. Yeah. Not disliking it, not hating it. Let me quickly chisel some of this. I'm just going to chisel that back just to make life a bit easier in my inventory. And I would like, right, now let's have a look at tables. The biblio, I think I've got a bit of, yeah, of course we've got, right, so we've got all of the usual table suspects, but I am going to go with a spruce table, which is that, and I want quite a few of those. So let me do, well, that's enough for 10. I would ideally like 20. Damn it. Getting a little bit tight there on getting the okay, and just do those three. Ideally, you actually want 30, don't I? So if I start, let me have a look. This is 1, 2, 3, 4. That's 3. So if that is going to be 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, it would make more sense to have another pile down the middle, wouldn't it? Although I am tempted to just take that back one. Or maybe even like that. No, I definitely think we need one. We need another bunch down the middle. We need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 more of these, so that's going to be 2, 4, 6, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I don't really want the extra one at this stage, so. Okay, so we've got a huge banqueting table. Mahusive banqueting table, even. Gonna need some wool. I'm gonna need quite a bit of wool, and I need to also clear my inventory out a little bit, but rather than clear it out down there, it would make more sense to clear it out up here. Just to preserve our sanity and stop us having to wander back down. I'm gonna go and grab some more stuff, and I will be. So for starters, I've got a whole load of various coloured wool. I've got blue, and I've got, well, various. I've got white. Damn it, I didn't want to do all of that. Oh, it doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. The white isn't going into the chairs. But the nice thing with the Bibliocraft stuff is the ability to whack a nice clean tablecloth on it. Now, one of the reasons why I've gone with windows in this part of the castle is, as castles in England anyway, as the place became more peaceful and castles evolved in function, they kind of evolved from being fortifications with very little in the way of home comforts into being more homely palaces. And let me have a look. And yeah, so this is kind of in that intermediary stage, if you like, for that, between somewhere between a heavy fortification and being a castle-y state. I mean, we tend to get them a lot with stately homes. So spruce, we need spruce, we need pressure plates, we need wool. Damn it. And does it have to be white wool? No doubt, knowing my luck, of course it will have to be white wool. Let's have some spruce. Let's have. We'll have those few sticks. We'll make some of those. So we're going wool. Better make the pressure plate first. Just make the one. It may even not work with these pressure plates. I've got a sneaking suspicion it won't. No, but the question is it not working with those pressure plates? Damn it, I need oak. I need oak, unless, I see, I don't want this wood stuff thing, I just want an oak pressure plate. I need some oak, damn it, damnation. I better shear some more sheep to get some more white wool as well while I'm down there, because you can't bleach that back, not that I've got bone meal to spare to bleach it anyway. So, yeah. We're going to have some, you know, some nice table decorations going on. We'll get it looking fancy. And I've got plans for the roof. Whether we'll get them done this episode or not is another matter. Because I'm going to need a lot of clay and I'm going to need a lot of wool. Although I have quite a bit of blue wool, so that's not too bad. And I've got, in fact, if I go and set Farmer Giles back up down here with feed to breed these guys, then we'll have even more blue wool, because he'll start breeding them and slaughtering them. But you need to get back in. Snip. Anybody else looking like? No, that's a lot. We'll have to check it, because I don't know whether it'll work with. I just heard another sheep eat some more bloody They do that. The moment your back's turned, they're gone. So I need some oak. Oak, if I were oak, where would I be? Good question. That's spruce. That's spruce. What the hell have I done with all my oak? Well, I can take that, and I'll take a little bit of that while I'm at it. Yeah. So that's going to be kind of the function of this, a kind of mix between for heavy fortified castle and stately, you know, home to impress the peasants and your visiting noblemen as they come in, you know. And as much, certainly toward the latter end of the castles, the castle was as much a symbol to impress and cow obedience into the peasants, kind of to make them, they look, I live in this great massive place, how rich must I be, as they were functionally functional for fortification purposes. Right, oh god, inventory is starting to look like my usual inventory here, so apologies for that. Now, do you work? No, you don't. Do you work? Of course you do. I need another pressure plate, don't I? Damn it. Another pressure plate, thank you. So I've only got sticks for this yet, but we'll get there. So you get all of that kind of stuff going on, and then you've got the backs, and I want to get this. Shall we go with these for the things? So those are wool. I see, I just need so much white wool. And sticks. We need a fair bit of as well. Let's sleep quickly. Because the guests, the visiting guests, would have slightly less impressive chairs than the host. The host would almost be enthroned. Because again, it's all about status and position and power. Surprising how often it comes down to that, isn't it, really? Even in this day and age. You only have to look at going to the office and you get the person in take the phrase power suit. I mean, that says everything you need to know, doesn't it, really? Right, so I want to do these ones, which is that. So we're going to do some stickies, like so. We're going to do a couple of those, and a couple of those. And then if I want to go to that, we just combine those with slabs. And then if we take those, so we'll get a feel for the plaything. So, right, what we got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So if I go 1, 2, 3, 4, that's right, that's perfect. 1, 2, and obviously I need to do more of this going on, but you've got your chairs. We can, he says, I'm fairly certain you can, or is it the carpet you use? Maybe the carpet. Which you can't do that way. And I bet I can't die. Let's just try it. The worst that can happen is this doesn't work, and I may go with blue, actually, because I've got lots of blue. I don't have lots of white to waste. Let's try that then. Oh yes, there we go. Very swish indeed. So yeah, I've got enough white wool currently for another four chairs, which will take me to two, and then to either side we'll have one at the foot, one at the other end of the table. So let me get what we can build done. I'll go and shear some sheeps again in a little while, and we'll see how we go. All right, so I'm going to try and get the roof done before we finish today. Well, the ceiling, not the roof, the ceiling. But I just wanted to have brought a few odds and sods. I also want to get these in place while we think about it. Now, they are not appropriate None of these are particularly brilliant. That's probably about the best we're going to get, I think. Chisel. Chisel, and we'll pop you in there, and we shall have, what shall we go for? That, perhaps. Yeah, that's kind of got a good solid feel to it. I also brought up a few items of DecoCraft stuff with me. So, we'll start off, we've got the place setting. Oop, that's not what we wanted. That's placed it on the table. What we wanted to do was place it like that. So, sitting around, they've got the dinner. We've got a whole roast hog. We've got some turkey. We've got some sweet rolls. We've got a fruit bowl. We've also got some candles. So what we can do here is let's go with the turkey. So maybe one like that. Where's my pig platter? Now the pig platter's pretty large, so we'll have that there. And then maybe the sweet rolls. Fruit, no. We'll stick that off. We'll do something else with that, I think. And then we'll have a... that is not working. Right. It won't go there. We can certainly get a candle here and here in the middle. Now, this is pretty poorly lit. And there's other stuff we can throw in there, but I think I'll get some more of these for the play settings. That's probably a done deal. Put the fruit basket away. Of course, this is a lord's room, so you know there's a very good chance he would have his bear head and maybe his trophies on display on the walls. So that's a useful one. Maybe a zombie head. Somewhere, I don't know. I'll leave that. I don't want to go overboard because I think there is such a thing as too much decoration. And what we can do is get some of this stuff going. Let's have a look. How's our lighting looking now? That's not too bad. Get the wall sconces up. Maybe here and here. We've still got some issues we'll have to address, but yeah, getting the lighting is kind of it's one of those things where you want to be certain you're getting it right, but at the same time, not too anal about it, for want of a better word. Now, I don't want the roof to be, could do with some more of that as well. In fact, let's bring the whole lot. Let's just leave those. And we'll grab some scaffold. And we'll... So I said about there, didn't I? Now, if I go 1, 2, so if I'm going at that height, and this is, I've kind of gone for this wood, because I didn't want the ceiling to look too polished, if that kind of makes any sense. I mean, it is a castle. Much of the structure, even if it were being, you know, repurposed as the Lord's perfectly wonderful holiday home, yeah, it's a timeshare, would still be original to when its function was more martial, more military or orientated. So yeah, I think that kind of don't want to fall off here. I don't fall well. Right. No, I can't chisel a stake, but I can chisel that and that. I may need more spruce, but spruce is not a problem. I have got loads of spruce. Right, let's get... And the top of this will then have a peaked roof. Possibly a little bit chintzy, actually, if I'm... The design I'm kind of thinking about is a little bit on the fairy tale kingdom side, but yeah, it's a very grey box. It needs some colour, so I think using the roofs to do that is probably not such a bad idea. Again, it's just using a feature which we can exploit to make it a little bit more interesting, I hope. But that'll be next time, because I am going to have to go and dig a whole metric crap ton of clay for that. And I don't think you can buy clay from the village shop things, you know, the little villager shops. Can I... Can't quite get any further than that. I've probably got 8 blocks left anyway, so let's just see how far we can get. Well, at least as far as there. Oops. I'll just take my scaffold down. I need to grab, as I say, some more spruce. I also really, realistically need to just stab a few basic torches down just to make sure. That was nearly nasty. Just to make sure that we, you know, these areas that are not lit are at least lit while we're building. Because what we don't want is to walk in here and have a creeper blow up and destroy everything after you spend all the time. That's the only thing I dislike about creepers. As, you know, in a building game, he says, as it's pitch black outside, you know, the yes, I can see, I mean, they're iconic to the game for starters, so, speaking of the devil, and they shall lurk. But, oh, hello. Yes. Speak of the devil, and he shall appear. Right, so I need a little bit more spruce. I also want to grab some chandeliers for this, so we'll... Oh, hello. I don't know where you think you're going. Well, I know where you think you're going. You think you're going round here, don't you? Anyway, let me grab my stuff and be ready to repel boarders. There he is. So, we'll just sort this chucklehead out. And, yeah, I'll grab my stuff and I'll be back just as soon as I've worked out how the hell I get around here. And make sure there's none coming in from this angle either. Because those zombies are persistent. They do like a nice fresh villager. No, I think we're clear. Right. Okay, I've just put the remains of the ceiling on. So all that remains really is just... Well, not all that remains. There's still quite a bit that remains. But what I want to do for starters is have a little bash at, let's turn you back into plank, shall we? So I need some sticks, and I think it was just that and that to get 2 banners. And these are small banners. So these are from Yigamo Chattels. Have to be careful when you say that. can dye them purple, because of course purple is the colour of our kingdom. And they're not the nicest banners, but you know, they do work. Put one there, one similarly there. I've also got the rest of the place settings for these guys, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. I brought some of these because I thought these would make interesting sideboard, you know. So we pop one there, and then we get the other half, and kind of, again, put some stuff in the place, makes it look a little bit busier. And we can take that fruit bowl, for example, if we can get it to go on here. And that can go on there, and we can get some more decorations going on around the place there. What else? We've got the... I've got to be one of the most bloody awkward. Go there. But do I want it there? Not really. I'd rather have, let me just stab these down a second. Right, where's my dirt? I will find a use for these guys one day, I swear. So, what we got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. What is that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. It's 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. It'd be easy just to count here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Ish. Kinda. On there. So that was where? That was three in. Get the old big chandeliers going. They're not going to provide much light because obviously they're way up in the sky there. But 1, 2, 3, maybe one there. And then if we go 1, 2, 3 there, and 1, 2, 3, I think there, maybe. I think that one actually wants to come over one. Did I even do that? 1, 2, 3, 4, yes I did. Alright. God, obviously having a huge chandelier on the ceiling is a pretty iconic image for a castle. I mean, you know, without that, what would you swash your buckle on when you want to swing? Can't help think that one, these wanted to come in one. You probably actually wanted to be lowered down a bit as well. There is a way to do this. Let me check how long I've been recording for one, because I'm positive that I'm a little bit over. And if we have time, oh dear, it's night time again, I will just try that one out quickly before we finish for the episode. So I'll be back in a... And next time, I'm at 39 minutes, I'm way, way over. But this is starting to come on. I do need to just kind of balance the lighting out a little bit in here. I've still got some of these wall sconces left, so, you know, I can possibly do that on here and here, and similarly we can do something down here perhaps, and there. But I'm not unhappy with that. I think that kind of is working well. We've got a large banqueting hall. I do need to do something with those, which I will do before next episode. A little bit of additional decoration here and there. If I can figure out how to get these damn knights in, I will do. I just can't see. I mean, it won't even go there. It'll go there, but not there. There just seems to be no way to get these to go. Anyway, yeah. So until next time, guys, thank you very much for watching. We've got a fairly integral room in the keep built. And, we'll continue on with that progress. We still need a minstrel's gallery, a few bits and pieces, but bang, almost done. Anyway, I will see you next time. Bye for now.